So the Army is still working on its next generation squad weapon, basically the replacement for the M4 and the M16. New caliber, new ranges, new capabilities. That's still at least a year away from getting to soldiers. In the meantime, they're also selecting the fire control, basically the optic for that. And two different companies are competing for that contract, Vortex Optics and L3 Harris. Essentially, what the new scope is going to do is give some augmentation for aiming. It's going to pretty much walk you on target the way systems might have done in, say, an Abrams or a Stryker. It'll take into account environmental situations and conditions such as humidity, ballistics information from different rounds and distances you have to shoot from. And it'll also, in the future, link into the integrated visual augmentation system, or the new kind of do-it-all goggle that soldiers will use. And that way you can tie in the goggle to the sight, and the two can talk together. And there's a new software program called Rapid Target Acquisition, which essentially will find targets that look like what you're trying to be shooting at, whether it's through dust or other types of obscurant, different types of conditions, and be able to lock that weapon onto that target, almost like a fighter pilot does with his missiles. So this new fire control is essentially is going to be selected down in the next couple weeks, sometime in the fall. That will then go on to the weapon. The weapon is set to field, or at least get to soldiers, by 2022. So this new scope far outdoes the old ACOGs and, of course, the old iron sights that a lot of older soldiers and Marines had to deal with, and gives pretty much next generation advanced type futuristic optics and targeting for even the average soldier, average grunt out there with their new weapon. Now, for a long time, a lot of these capabilities existed in different platforms. You had a rangefinder to find the distance. You had ways of measuring or using ballistic computers in a kind of a heavier, more range setting to figure out kind of where your bullet was falling on the target. But what they're trying to do is take all these technologies that existed in multiple devices and put them down into one small package. Now, the science is there. I mean, there are sensors to do that. It's just an expensive proposition. Getting these things together in the right kind of price and the right kind of ability, and also making it rugged and durable for soldiers and Marines, is key. And that's really been some of the hurdles in recent years. But a lot of funding behind this Army project and how it's going to tie into the next generation squad weapon have really pushed that ball forward, and we're seeing some real big advances in optics in just the last couple of years. So the Army has really been looking at this program for a number of years, but just earlier this year, in early 2021, 115 prototypes from these two companies went to the Army for further evaluation and testing. Soldiers have used them, soldiers have tested them and given their feedback. They're going to select one of the two prototypes to move forward with this fall. And essentially what that's going to do is allow that optic to be fielded with the new weapon sometime in 2022, first to special operations and frontline soldiers, infantry, close combat forces. It's probably not going to flow to the rest of the Army or the Marine Corps for many years, but initially those frontline soldiers and Marines will have that optic on their weapon as soon as next year or shortly afterward.